ultimate security guard at Shea Stadium for the last 26 years. And I've met a lot of guys, and I just wanted to tell you that Tony Clark is probably the nicest guy you ever want to meet.
He is a very classy man. I've known Tony Clark a very long time, and he is a very classy individual. He's got a great view. He could be the next guy to run the Players Association. He is a, which would be interesting to have an ex-player running it. He is a very bright man and a very good guy. Absolutely true.
Yeah, my son and I were sitting in the Yankee Stadium on right behind first base, and he was doing calisthenics, and we waved to him, and he came over, took a picture with us, and I had a question for him. He once hit a shot in the old Yankee Stadium up on the black on the left-hand side. I mean, I had to be at least 450, so I asked him how many feet it was, and they wouldn't tell me because I was playing for Detroit at the time.
Yeah, you know, he had a lot of power. I mean, he had years in Detroit, 30 homers, 100 RBIs, 32 homers, 33 homers. I mean, he had some big years. He was a slugger early in his career. Then he was a guy who hit some home runs off the bench for the Yankees, played for a lot of different teams. But a very, very, you know, good guy. And a guy who's kind of done everything in baseball. He went from a role player, he was a home run hitter, then he became a role player. So across the board, he did a very good job. We'll take a quick break and be right back. Thanks for the call. I appreciate it. Thanks, you. We'll be right back.
If your eyes could sing, would they sound like this? Or would they rock like this? Turn up your eyes' volume with Fresh Look Color Blends contact lenses. From Get You Notice Grace to Backstage Blues. Virtually try on any color at freshlookcontacts.com. Or look for the Fresh Look Eye Studio at PNC Bank Arts Center. Don't just see with your eyes.
Contact lenses is needed if worn for cosmetic reasons or medical devices that must only be worn under the prescription, direction, and supervision of a eye care professional. Serious eye health problems can occur. Ask your eye doctor for safety instructions.
I'm Tom Popo with the CBS Sports Minute. The All-Star Game isn't so much about the score, which was 3-0 American League last night, but about memories. About remembering Cal Ripken's home run out of Chan Hall Park in his last All-Star appearance, or Bo Jackson's titanic shot off Rick Rushel in Anaheim. Last night, what will I remember? Mariano Rivera. The number 42 will be worn no more in All-Star games, and the fact that Jim Leland gave him center stage walking out to enter Sandman all by himself. No one on the field, just the fans' ovation. How cool was that? And when you heard, my apologies, Metallica. What do you think of? What do you think of the Sandman putting people to sleep? And you think of Mariano Rivera putting games to sleep? I'm Tom Tom.
The road hates your engine. They are adversaries, enemies, foes. The road will attack your engine with dirt, dust, and grime. Through your air filter, any way it can. Fight back. Reclaim the horsepower the road tries to steal. Every 12,000 miles, it's easy to change to a Fram air filter that keeps dirt, dust, and grime out of your engine. If it's on the road, there's a Fram in this. Find your Fram air filter at your local Walmart. More with less. More
something familiar. This is what Benny and our team are here every day. The IBM System X3650M4 Express Server intends it says do no more 4 months. It's easy to manage, designed to deliver 84% greater performance, and can handle as many workloads as 25 prior generation IBM systems, all at an affordable price. Like how that sounds? Learn more at ibm.com/more4months.
If searching for a Ford, go to tristateford.com.
All right, we're back here at Bethpage Black Player Association event for the Hurricane Relief. And if there's a man who's a match for Bethpage Black, I would say it was Jim Heitz, who's as long a hitter as there is. How was it out there for you, Jim?
Not today. You can tell the New Yorker back here.
Yeah, that's right. That's it.
How'd you hit it today?
Did you keep it in the fairway today or what?
No.
This is a rough course, you know.
It's a very rough course, but I think the guys that played the course today, they really enjoyed it. One thing I think that really stands out more than anything else, because we had the U.S. Open here because of the Bethpage Black.
Yes, absolutely. You were a player at being able to hit the golf ball on body. You're still
short. Like this here. No. I think, you know, it's like everything else. You just got to play in position. Those are the key things. You just got to play in position.
I remember when he used to put you out on the runway with those big steel shafts on to see how far you could get it. I mean, you let it go. I mean, you hit the ball a lot. surprised me is Lackey. After all the nightmarish stuff we heard, and he used to be a great competitor, looks like he's got his game all the way back, Lackey. Huh? He's pitched really well.
I think after talking to you, I haven't heard anything. The only thing I know about Lackey is this: when I went to spring training, I said, something's wrong with this guy. I mean, this guy came down. He was in the best shape I've ever seen this guy. And of course, with the Tommy John surgery, it seemed like the velocity has improved, right? And he's more dedicated. I mean, you know, I think when he was out there with the Angels, he was considered a leader. Before he came here, he had Buck Coach, had Lester, and back and forth, he sort of fell back on the back page. So now he's been that roll back as well.
Can the Red Sox survive if you have at the back of the
I think with the way things are going, it's almost like the players. You have a different reliever, a different stopper, as the four comes, I call them stoppers. But every other day, you may have someone step in because everyone's on a pitch count.
Right.
So, I mean, he may be on a pitch count today throwing 30 pitches. Tomorrow, he may not be able to throw it 2 days later. So I think anytime you have some guys in a row with their will to play, you can throw anyone out there to be the closer that day. Not necessarily for the year, but for that day.
Yeah, I tell you, it's an interesting race. It probably will be the rest of the way in the American League East, and the Red Sox have gotten a leg up on everybody and played really terrific baseball. We're talking with a Hall of Famer, and it's nice to say now because he deserved it for a long time, Jim Rice, Hall of Famer, as the Yanks will be up there, limping up there right now, hoping to get some reinforcements. I know the Red Sox folks aren't going to be too worried about the Yankees, so I feel sorry for them, but hopefully right now the Yanks are a little run challenge, Jim. They could use a Jim Rice in the middle of that lineup. A nice right-handed bat would be helpful right now, you know that?
But thank you. But the Red Sox are living also, because you go back and you look, I don't think the Red Sox, when they broke camp in spring training, they had a set 9 guys they wanted to start with, and they have not had that. Everyone's hurt. You go out and you have maybe 4 or 5 games, next thing you know, you do something, because I think you look at the matchups. So when you have the matchup, some guys want to sit in today, some guys want to sit out. Of course, you have that matchup when you're sitting on the bench for that pitcher to come in.
You know, I was thinking, watching some of these kids last night, thinking about when I watched some youngsters break in. You watch Harper, and I was watching Trout, all these young guys at the All-Star game, thinking about what, you know, when they say, boy, rookies didn't break in the old days like this. Well, Freddie Lynn broke in like that. You and Lynn, when you broke in, with a big splash. There was no question about it. You guys were two big offensive players when you broke in. I mean, big-time offensive players, joining Yastrzemski and guys like that. You guys made a big difference right away.
Yes, we did. I think by going to spring training and having three spring training with the big league club, you have a tendency of learning. And of course, they tell you how you're able to adapt, how you're able to make changes in your swing, make changes in your makeup as far as going out and doing the things that you got to do to get in the big leagues. A lot of guys are doing the right things to get in the big leagues, but are they doing the right thing to stay in the big leagues?
Right.
In order to stay in the big leagues, you got to be able to adjust when you're a hitter. Every pitch, not every bat. And I think once they get in the head that I got to make an adjustment every pitch, I'll be okay. And I got to learn how to hit the breaking ball. Why? Because every pitch, you're going to throw you 4 pitches.
What was the key to you being so consistent? Why were you such a... Because you were a tremendously consistent player. What was the secret? Were you healthy all the time? Did you not have a lot of injuries? I mean, what made you such a consistent player?
Work, dedication, and 2 guys that played left field before me.
Did you hit a lot?
No, we didn't hit a lot.
You didn't hit a lot? So you don't believe in guys hitting a lot, right?
I believe in hitting, but you got to hit the right way.
Okay.
I think a lot of guys, when they take extra hitting, they're not hitting the right way. They're hitting to hit the ball in the ballpark to see how far they can hit the ball. We were taught to hit line drives. We were taught to hit the ball through someone. These guys want to lift the ball, see how far they can hit it. If we did that, Don Zimmer would have called me and said, hey, look, we don't play it up here. You got to hit line drives. You got to be able to hit the ball the opposite field. You got to be able to do small things. You got to be able to handle fundamentals. Inside out the pitch, hit the ball to right side, get the man from first to third. Guys now, they don't do this. All stars in college and high school, but I think high school may not use it back in college. When you use aluminum bats, guys are not able to handle the ball if they had wooden bats.
What's up, boy? Jim Rice, you talked about the two fielders. Yastrzemski you played with, did Williams have a big impact even in spring training on you guys growing up? Like, was he around there? Was he the booming voice? Was he a big influence on you, Williams?
He was the booming voice, but he and Yaz went it all the time. You know, they had different theories. And he was my hitting instructor the whole 15 years I was there. And I just listened to Johnny. Johnny said, hey, look, line drive. That's all he wants, line drive. Just line drive the ball to right field, line drive to left, gap to gap.
He used to hit 40-foot line drives. So he didn't hit, like, you know, 300-foot line drives. You hit that line drives out of the ballpark. That was the difference.
And that little Yankee Stadium out there. Right field out of London.
He used to work the Yankees over pretty good, you know. But those were some fun years. You know, that 1978 still was one of those great years. It was a fun. I know it didn't end up the way you wanted, but that was a fun year. It really was. The amazing thing that people forget is you guys came back that last week after you got Yankees caught you. You came back, won 7 or 8 in a row. The Yanks lost to Rick Waite the last day of the season to force that playoff. You guys showed a lot of toughness coming back once you got passed.
And I always tell people, they say, how many games in a year? I say 162. I said, no, at one time it was 163.
That's right.
And I played 163.
Absolutely.
Played 163 and missed one at bat.
163 and missed one at bat. And it ended with the Yastrzemski pop up in the Nettles glove. And what was a great ball game.
But then you didn't say anything about Bucky Dent loaded bat.
I don't know anything about Bucky Dent.
Okay, Mickey Rivers was a bad guy.
I do know that, you know, the play was... which irks you guys is Pinella making that play in the sun field, right? I mean, if Pinella doesn't make that play in right field, you guys probably win that game. You know, he made that great play in the sun. He probably lucky he stamped that ball, you know that?
You know, even though he made that play, but I think it was Burleson. If Burleson go ahead and I think it was Burleson, not Remy. If he go ahead and just go from first to third,
yep.
Pinella can't make that throw anyway because his arm not that strong.
Right.
So that would have changed the game also, but, you know, it just wasn't in the Red Sox favor.
It was a wonderful season. And a great, great, great year, no question about it. And, you know what amazes me too, Jimmy? See these young players now. It seems like last night, watching the young guys walk around, they get on equal footing right away now in the majors. Like, it seems like walking around, guys like Trout and Harper are already established as big stars at a very young age. It's not, it doesn't seem like they have the initiation phase that maybe you guys went through where, you know, the bigger stars maybe didn't give you guys as much reverence as they give these young guys nowadays. I think they become sort of pretty quickly now.
They become stars very quickly, but still, you look at the guys that you're talking about, they're still not in that fundamental stage. How can you get cut off, guys? I mean, you're not tagging them, you're not in a position to throw the balls. I think a lot of times you're out there and you as a young player, you want to showcase, you want to be the spotlight.